With the emergence of near-peer adversaries and the ever-increasing cost of tactical aircraft acquisition costs, Kratos unmanned aerial systems has been at the forefront of the development of reusable or attritable unmanned aerial systems for use in manned-unmanned teaming operations in a contested environment. Kratos unmanned aerial systems leveraged its domain knowledge of high-performance subscale aerial targets to design, develop, and demonstrate the first purpose-built attritable unmanned aerial systems. Kratos is at the forefront of delivering a family of innovative, affordable, expeditionary, and high-performance tactical unmanned aerial systems. The Valkyrie XQ-58A is a combat drone designed to deliver weapons or assist fighter jets using artificial intelligence. The prototype has been in development for years and is able to travel 3,000 miles at an altitude of up to 45,000 feet. Experts now say this unmanned vehicle could play a role in a multi-billion dollar military effort to use AI to expand its assets to keep up with increasingly advanced adversaries like China. Operate in swarms. Combined with its affordability, survivability, long range, high subsonic speeds, maneuverability, and ability to carry flexible mission kit configurations and a mix of lethal weapons from its internal bomb bay and wing stations. The Valkyrie's ability to be pre-deployed and operated remotely without requiring runway or airfield operations make it a critical deterrence for near-peer adversaries, while delivering maximum operational flexibility and utility to the U.S. warfighter. With design and production approaches leveraged and evolved from Kratos's affordable jet drone target aircraft, the high-performance Valkyrie falls well within the attritable cost class, as defined by the House passed 2024 National Defense Authorization, ACT, another key discriminator and enabler to achieve the Department of Defense's mass mission. The latest Marine XQ-58 test flight was conducted from the U.S. Air Force's Eglin Air Force Base in Florida on September 20, but was only announced publicly today. The new Marine XQ-58 test demonstrated newly added Link 16 capabilities for the uncrewed collaborative combat aircraft prototype. Initial results indicate that the prototype met threshold requirements for autonomously exchanging relevant tactical information. These Link 16 capabilities significantly enhance the Marine Air Ground Task Force's ability to conduct integrated and joint operations. The Marines have now conducted 3 XQ-58 flight tests, as the service continues to explore how it might use these or other drones in various roles, including as uncrewed electronic warfare aircraft, surveillance and reconnaissance platforms, airborne communications relay, or wingmen for crewed fighters like the F-35. Last month, the company also announced that it had developed a special launch trolley that allows existing Valkyries without built-in landing gear to make use of traditional runways. The addition of landing gear, especially for a version of Valkyrie that is still able to carry weapons and other stores internally, points to a derivative that will likely be larger and heavier than existing variants. The new XQ-58 version with built-in landing gear could also be higher performance as a result. A new version of the stealthy XQ-58 Valkyrie with built-in landing gear is in the works, the drone's manufacturer Kratos has disclosed. A new version of the stealthy XQ-58 Valkyrie with built-in landing gear is in the works, the drone's manufacturer Kratos has disclosed. Kratos had previously announced that a third launch and recovery method for the Valkyrie was on the horizon, but without providing specific details. The drone was originally designed to be entirely runway independent, getting into the air using a static ground-based launcher with the help of expendable rocket boosters, and then using a parachute recovery system at the end of a sortie. The XQ-58 continues to the most visible of Kratos's tactical drone offerings. The newly announced version with internal landing gear, which could be of great interest to the Air Force, shows that work is still being done to significantly expand the scale and scope of capabilities found within the still-growing Valkyrie family.
Thank you. Yeah, don't go this way.
Can we get in here?
Come down some, okay?
Yeah.